Hello, everybody. This is the one and only Mr. LP, Steven Sykes of Enliven Global Media. We're here in Richmond, Virginia, and I'm here with the one and only Shion Fenty. How are you doing today, ma'am?
I'm doing great. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing all right now. We are here at your victory party. Regardless of the results, we still say it's a victory because we got a whole lot of wonderful things coming up. So tell me, how do you feel about today?
I feel really great about today. We've done a lot of things over the entire 6 months, which is amazing to me. In 6 months, we were able to reach people's hearts and help them to understand that the message to educate and empower really isn't just a message, that it's our heartbeat, that it is time to help people to improve their lives. So I feel like the message has gone across really well. And of course, I wish I would have won this evening, but it is such a blessing to be able to be embraced, to be able to understand what it is that we were trying to do and to watch things change. And that's what I'm going to be working towards for the rest of my life, is to watch transformation and change.
Now, you being here in the Richmond area for a long time, what are some of the key issues that you, with your campaign, although we all know, but for those who may not be familiar, what were some of the things that you were trying to bring out within your campaign?
Definitely, to using using our economy to our advantage, where people can start small businesses to have their own financial freedom, for parents to be able to choose wherever they want to send their kids. There's a lot of children with special needs that cannot sit in a traditional classroom, so giving families that choice. And then also really, especially in the inner cities and in rural areas where there's no opportunities, we wanted to be able to create opportunities so kids, young adults, the elderly are able to live the lives that they were desiring to live.
Now, with your district that we're in, is a very large district and diverse. You know, a couple of districts fall through to here. When you mentioned something heavily about opportunities for kids, not rural, but, you know, jobs for kids, more activities, more programs. What are some of the key things you mentioned earlier in another meeting that you were going to bring in some more activities and things like that? Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Definitely. So we definitely need a lot of more after-school care items for kids. So whether it's the Cubs, like missionettes, anything, like people that have a lot of creative ideas. I was working with a company that was all about kids riding bikes and taking tours. Some people that were into mountain climbing, finding things where kids can use all of their mind, their body, their spirits, their souls. And then also making sure, like, for kids that may not want to go to a four-year college, we have to have trade schools. But also, more importantly, there are a lot of subcultural issues that aren't being dealt with, that we're talking about. How about recidivism? This reciprocation of people going back to prison for whatever reason, but we got to provide things in there that stops that cycle. And I believe after school care and opportunities for kids and young adults to be able to do things and to have the opportunity will begin to stop that cycle.
One of my biggest issues with the cycle is the opportunity for work, because a lot of the programs, they say, okay, we have all these job training programs, whatever, but you can't get out there to work, or they kind of stereotype you to have only labor type of jobs, but only blue collar jobs, but not white collar and other things. What some of the things are, for me, I believe there's some rule changes that need to be made so we can have it opportunities. And also, you know, when you try to return back to your homes, if you happen to be in housing, you can't return back to your family if they happen to be in housing. Certain subdivisions, certain places won't give you a loan for a house. There's a lot of barriers that people are unaware of. You even pay higher for car insurance and things. There's a lot of barriers that are in place for those who have a record and felony, who's just trying to be reintroduced back into life.
Definitely. And so those are the things in the criminal justice reform that have to be changed. That just, if you have like a non-violent anything on your record, that should not hold you back from getting a job. Those, that really needs to be looked at. And some of, we really have to stand up and encourage leaders and lawmakers to begin to make a change in that, because it doesn't make sense for someone to not be able to have a life after they paid their time. They paid their time, and why are they paying double time after they come out of prison? And the other thing is, too, when it comes to these different employment opportunities, I was speaking with a business owner earlier today who's into technology, and he's also an engineer, and I was saying, I'd love to have your company begin to do some training in our communities, and he was more than happy to be able to do so. And this is an engineering firm, and yes, there will have to be educational classes to go along with it, but once you have the education and you have the practice, practical, it's easy to understand. It's easy to begin to have those skills. And this is, again, you have to match people in the different fields that they're going to go into to have that mentorship. That mentorship is so important.
Going forward, there's a lot of different things with disabilities. There's a lot of people we hear about, you know, mental health, but there's also some other things with disabilities, such as those of vision impaired, hearing. Sometimes may not have gotten as much attention as some of the other forms of disabilities and more resources for that. What are some of the things that this area could do a lot better to help change that.
Definitely. So I'm a person, I'm always going to staff my weaknesses, and this is not a strong suit of mine. So a few of the companies or organizations that I have spoken to, they've come up with a lot of great ideas, and they're saying all they're doing is a lack of funding as to why they cannot implement some of these things. So again, I'm going to research. I'm a researcher. I'm going to find a way to make things happen. And so there are places that can write grants, which I was hoping to, at the federal level, begin to write those grants, release some funding into this. And so now we're going to really have to take the grassroots effect here and begin to work our way up to make these things happen, because the funding is there. The opportunities are there. And so for the visually impaired, the hearing impaired, they have opportunities that they want to be able to take advantage of.
Exactly.
But there has to be the funding there to be able to create those innovative ideas to make them happen.
And a lot of them want to work, but just cannot get the opportunity to.
Yes, exactly.
What does tomorrow, Wednesday, look like for you?
Oh my goodness. But quite honestly, it's like almost like every other day. I've worked full-time during this campaign.
You work full-time in the campaign,
yes.
But you know, other than that, you know, the limo and everything.
Oh yeah, right. Yeah, right. So I have a full-time job. I'm going back to work tomorrow, just like I do every single day. And it's just, I tell you what, during this campaign, I feel like I've come into my own. I know exactly who I am. I feel like I already knew that before, but there's certain things that kind of push you over that edge. And so it's just like you're coming back into that. And I have a big vision for this city. I have a big vision for millennials, young adults, entrepreneurs, people that want to do something. And we're going to put some steps behind that to make it happen.
For those young women out there that's getting out there and learning and get involved in politics or other businesses, and you being an independent business owner, throughout this journey, what is one thing that you learned about yourself that you didn't learn, that you did not know before?
I did not know I had a supremely bulldog tenacity. I knew that I was tough, but I had no idea that I would lock jaw and not let go. That's been an awesome.
So your bulldog in a skirt.
Yes.
Okay, there we go. All right. Now, last question. What's your favorite prayer?
My favorite prayer? Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. That's been my prayer every single day of this campaign, because there's so many things that can make you upset, that can change your heart. But I refuse to lose my character through this. I refuse to become someone I'm not, and I refuse to hold grudges. So that's been my prayer every single day. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Amen. Thank you so very much for taking your time to speak with us. And thank you, everybody. And then how can people get in contact to follow up and get some information? And
friend me on Facebook right now. Until we get everything launched, just friend me on Facebook and ask there.
And email?
No email. Friend me on Facebook.
Not a problem.
Yes,
all right.
I need to shut down media for a little
not
bit.
Not a
right
problem.
Now.
Not a problem. But I thank you very much for your time. I appreciate it. And
yeah,
God bless you. And thank you so very much.
Thank you.
Bye bye.